Gay and lesbian people exist in every Orthodox community, in every shul, in every school, yeshiva, and seminary. Some are ready to share their identities publicly, while others remain closeted. But each of these Jews, many in their teens or young adulthood, are searching for their place in the Torah observant world. They are looking to us. They are looking to leaders of the Orthodox institutions, as well as to their friends, parents, and fellow community leaders to offer them guidance and protection and to denounce those who do them harm. They want to be welcomed as members of the Torah observant Jewish community. One of the reasons that gay and lesbian individuals feel unwelcomed by the religious world is rooted in a verse from this week's Torah portion, Achrimot Kedoshim, Ve'et Zachar lo tishkav mishkavei isha to'evahi. Do not have relations with a male as one has relations with a woman. It is abhorrent. This is the starting point for Orthodox Jews. Certain acts of sexual intimacy between two men is strictly and uncompromisingly forbidden by the Torah. However, even as we acknowledge this fact, we must recognize that simply being gay or lesbian is not a transgression. Moreover, there are other verses in the Torah which also govern our behavior towards the gay and lesbian community. One of them is found in the second of this week's parashiyot, Vahafta l'reyacha kamocha. We are commanded to love our neighbor as ourselves, to relate to our peers with respect and love. Another verse mentioned later in the book of Vayikra also provides us guidance of how to relate to the gay and lesbian community. The pasuk of V'lo tonu ish et amito v'yareta melokecha ki ani Hashem elokechem. Do not wrong one another. Fear your God, for I am the Lord your God. This is the absolute prohibition against bullying, against verbal harassment, known as onat varim, to which members of the gay and lesbian community are so often subjected. Time and again, the conversations I have with members of the LGBTQ Orthodox Jewish community come back to hurtful language, whether intended or not, and makes them feel that they don't belong. Halacha has high expectations of the way we speak and engage with others, and we are called upon to reinforce those expectations. Tragically, we have created a suffocating environment that not only prevents gay and lesbian Orthodox Jews from attaining spiritual fullness, but also one that fosters low self-esteem, loneliness, and fear, pushing away these Jews and pushing a higher than average percentage to depression, self-harm, and most tragically, death by suicide. Beyond all else, the most crucial step for us to take is to listen with sincerity and sensitivity to make sure they know that they can remain part of our family and of our community. Already in the late 1800s, religious leaders, including the great Rav Azriel Hildesheimer and Rav Yitzchak Elchanan Spector, welcomed those who have a fragmented relationship to Judaism to take part in the Orthodox communal life. Facing the question of whether to give aliyot to Jews who were nearly entirely non-observant, both of these poskim ruled of the overwhelming need to encourage people to remain connected to Judaism, even those not fully engaged. Therefore, they justified calling them to the Torah even on Shabbat and Yom Tov when they were not observant of these holidays. Rav Hildesheimer stated that Jews who do not wish to abandon their commitment to be part of the covenant, even if they have abandoned certain aspects of religious practice, are still welcomed into the synagogue, into our community. Rav Spector went even further, welcoming those who had not even undergone circumcision. If we are willing to include in our community those who forgo Brit Milah, those who desecrate the Shabbos publicly, why should it be any different for those in the gay and lesbian community who would never dream of breaking the Shabbat, but who through no fault of their own, own an identity that presents halachic challenges? Rav Aaron Lichtenstein discusses the responsibility that we have to accept Jews as they are and recognize the contributions that each can bring to our community. Rav Lichtenstein explains that it is wrong both morally and halachically, to sever ties with individuals who are not fully engaged in the full complement of Jewish observance. I'd like to conclude by quoting a part of a letter written by Rav Aaron Feldman, Rosh Yeshiva of Neir Yisrael in the United States. He wrote this to a man attempting to reconcile his homosexuality with his commitment to a life of Torah and mitzvot. Rav Feldman wrote that homosexuals, and I quote, are as beloved in God's eyes as any other Jew. They are obligated to achieve life's goals by directing his life towards spiritual growth, sanctity, and perfection of his character, no less than any other Jew. He continues that in his discussion with this gentleman, that he will merit the same share in the world to come which every Jew merits, minimally by being the descendant of Avraham Avinu, and maximally by totally devoting his life towards service to God. In the spirit of Rav Feldman's words, may we always be mindful of the fact that all Jews, whether gay or straight, are beloved by Hashem, and that all deserve our love and our acceptance. Shabbat Shalom.